What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Blue Blood Sports TV, back at y'all with another one. So, we have some shocking news, as we have a new unified lightweight world champion superstar boxer, as George Kambosos Jr. upsets Teofimo Lopez and gets a split decision victory over Teofimo Lopez. George Kambosos, he dropped Teofimo Lopez early in the fight. George Kambosos Jr., you know, he was landing a jab left hook all night, overhand rights all night, and he got a split decision. Now, late in the fight, George Kambosos in the 10th round, George Kambosos, he got sloppy, he got too confident, and he got dropped in the 10th round, okay? But ultimately, he was dominating the fight. He was outboxing Teofimo Lopez. This was shocking. I didn't see this coming from a mile away. I thought that George Kambosos Jr. was going to lose this fight. I actually picked George Kambosos Jr. to get knocked out in this fight. I didn't see this coming. Not in a million years. I thought that George Kambosos Jr. would beat Teofimo Lopez, especially in the manner he beat Teofimo Lopez. Teofimo Lopez, there was reports and rumors that Teofimo Lopez, he was struggling with his weight, that Teofimo Lopez, you know, he couldn't make the weight. He announced that he was going to vacate the belt and he was going to move up to junior welterweight. He stated that he was at this weight limit far too long and he had to move up. So with that said, shocking, he looked very tired. He looked very fatigued, okay? And the quickness, the mobility, the athletic ability of George Kambosos Jr., it gave Teofimo Lopez tons and tons of problems, okay? We saw George Kambosos Jr., like I said, he was celebrating in the fight. He was showboating in the fight. He was very comfortable. Now, he got a little bit too comfortable in that 10th round, and he ultimately got dropped in the 10th round. But for the most part, George Kambosos Jr., he controlled this fight, okay? He won this fight clearly, handily. Now, I thought that he was definitely going to have to need the championship rounds, and which he did. He won 11 and 12, okay? Because, again, he got knocked down in the 10th round, which was shocking and was surprising. But Teofimo Lopez, you know, it showed his glaring weakness that he's going to struggle with boxers, okay? Pure boxers with athletic ability and quickness, he's going to struggle with those types of boxers. And no wonder Teofimo Lopez and his father training manager, Teofimo Lopez Sr., were looking to stay away from undefeated WBC lightweight world champion superstar boxer Devin the Dream Haney, okay? Teofimo Lopez, you know, he shocked the world. Not to me, because I picked Teofimo Lopez to beat Olympic two-time gold medalist, former three-division world champion, unified lightweight world champion, superstar boxer, Vasyl Hightech Lomachenko. I thought that Teofimo Lopez's athletic ability, his ability to cut off the ring, his ability to, to move around the ring. He's big, he's strong. I thought that would bother Vasyl Lomachenko, and I was 1,000% correct, okay? He won a unanimous decision victory over Vasyl Lomachenko. But what I didn't see is this tonight. Now, I did state this, okay? Rounds 8, 9, 10, round 7, 8, 9, and 10 against Vasyl Lomachenko, he showed a glaring weakness, okay? He showed that he was bothered by Lomachenko coming forward. He was bothered by Lomachenko's movement. He was bothered by Lomachenko's aggression, okay? And it showed, okay? Once again, it showed. And so with that said, you know, George Kambosos Jr.'s aggression, his will to come forward, and his counterpunch ability with his hand speed, it showed, okay? His foot speed. Teofimo Lopez was just following George Kambosos Jr. around the ring, okay? He was just looking to land one big punch. He came out very aggressive, swinging very wildly, and it ultimately cost him because he lost this fight. Now, another thing took place is Teofimo Lopez, he stated, "I won this fight," at the end of the round, at the end of the fight. Everybody knows the entire arena booed Teofimo Lopez. Now, he was in his hometown in New York. He's from Brooklyn, and the whole arena was cheering him on. But at the end of the fight, the whole arena booed him when he said, "I really won this fight," and they took the fight from me, so on and so forth. You did not win this fight. He clearly lost the fight, okay? And it seemed like they was looking for a reason to give him the fight. And one judge did give him the fight, 115-112, in a close fight, okay? But the other judges saw it pretty handily for George Kambosos Jr. So he was booed. He said he's going to go back to the drawing board. He's going to figure it out, see what he wants to do next. So we got to see how this unfolds and plays out. But Teofimo Lopez loses a split decision to George Kambosos Jr. George Kambosos Jr. at the end of the fight was asked about a rematch. Teofimo Lopez. He waiting on a rematch. He stated that he don't know if he wants to give a rematch because he struggled to make the weight. He said he wanted to hang out with his children, his family, because he'd been away from them too long. Teofimo Lopez, he announced already that he was moving up to junior welterweight, 140-pound division, and I believe that that's where he fits best, okay? So I believe you're going to see Teofimo Lopez move up. George Kambosos Jr., he said he has a lot of respect for Devin Haney. Obviously, Devin Haney, he wants to become undisputed in the lightweight division. He wants the accomplishment. So Devin Haney, he wants this fight. So George Kambosos Jr., he's going to want to take the fight to Australia. I don't know if Devin Haney's going to be willing to go to Australia. Next Saturday, Devin Haney has a big fight. He has a big fight with former IBF featherweight world champion, Mexican superstar boxer Joseph Jojo Diaz. So Devin Haney is going to have to secure that victory, which I highly expect him to secure the victory. And then we'll see what happens next. But this was shocking. I thought I picked Teofimo Lopez to win by 8th round knockout. And nothing of that, okay? It was nothing what I expected. The speed of George Kambosos Jr., the athletic ability, the movement, it gave Teofimo Lopez tons and tons of problems. And ultimately, it cost Teofimo Lopez the fight. Teofimo Lopez, he showed me that junior welterweight may not be the division for him, okay? Moving up to junior welterweight, that might not be a good look for Teofimo Lopez because the movement, the athletic ability, and the size of a guy like Josh Taylor, that would be too much. The pressure of a Regis Prograis, I believe that would be too much. You know, and Teofimo Lopez, again, he doesn't bowl well when you come forward. He doesn't look well when you're aggressive. So George Kambosos Jr. is not the biggest puncher in the world, and he's not the biggest guy. Teofimo Lopez clearly was the bigger man in this ring tonight. And he was very fatigued. He was very tired. And he ultimately lost. But let's see what happens next. That's all I got for y'all. Make sure you hit the like button. Drop a comment in the comment section. Let me know what y'all think. Y'all already know what it is. It's your boy Blue, Blue Blood Sports TV. Hate, like, comment, and subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, hit the subscribe button. Hit the like button. Hit the bell icon to get all the new notifications. Follow me on Instagram at Blue Blood Sports TV, all one word. Y'all already know what it is. Shout out to the entire LDBC. Shout out to New Media. Shout out to Black Media Row. Make sure you like and share these videos. That's all I got for y'all. Peace.